funny, if I'm talking funny, it's because my wisdom teeth are jacked up right now, and yes, I'm getting them removed, and yes, the army will remove your wisdom teeth for free. They even knock you out for it. So I'm gonna be under general anesthesia. A couple more questions that I've seen in the comments, as well as I'm gonna throw in some clips from transition to practice, just so you can see whatever, you know, how my experience was. So I take the NCLEX on the 9th. Wish me luck. And yeah, so you guys, if you have any more questions, continue to just comment in the comment section. You guys, don't forget to subscribe, don't forget to like, you know, all the fancy schmancy YouTube stuff. I will continue to respond as much as I can and answer questions in videos as much as I can as well. So here we go. So I just completed my first shift for transition of practice. It was overnight. It was 6:45 to 7:15 a.m. I'm not as tired as I thought I would be. I had 3 patients. I was kept busy. I was on med surge. Yeah. Ooh, I look pretty crazy right now. Sorry, but. Yeah, so for a transition to practice, I had 2 overnight shifts. And then a 5-day shifts. That first overnight shift was cool. It was easy. Like, I was good. The second overnight shift, I was like visibly dying. Like, I was like, I need to go to sleep. Like, it was horrible.
I apologize in advance. Like, every time I come on here or I'm meant to record, I always look crazy, but it is what it is. You know, people have to love you at your worst and love you at your best. I'm only human. But just a quick little update. Today's Sunday. I already worked my 2 overnight shifts for TTP, transition to practice. And tomorrow and for the rest of my, I think I have 5 shifts left. And those are all morning shifts. So day by day, I'll pull the updates in and then I'll let you know how it goes. See ya. Day 3 of transition to practice.
Sorry, but it's kind of awkward to be recording and like walking the hallways, obviously. But yeah. So day 3 of transition to practice. Actually, right now I'm taking a little break from the floor because I have to get my wisdom teeth looked at. They're bothering me. I don't know how the heck I'm gonna squeeze and get them removed before I leave, but hopefully they can get them out before I go because it's to the point where like, it's bothering me. So today's April 1st. Happy birthday, Jackson! I never felt for a girl like you. But yeah, have a good day. So I'm back in my room. So day 3 of transition to practice is officially complete. It was pretty good. I didn't do too much patient care today because my nurse was, my preceptor was charging, so she let me study, and it was amazing because, well, for the first 8 hours of the shift, I was following another nurse. I was going to have to do admissions and discharges, and once he was dismissed for the day, she let me just do some NCLEX stuff, and it was amazing because I got so much stuff done. And I finished so much that I was able to like start going over things that I got wrong. So like
I know I have a couple more things to go over, or a couple more things to memorize, like lab values. And, what's it called? Lab values and, blood serum values too. So for the next couple days, that's what I'm gonna be working on, just memorizing those values the best I can, and just, yeah, because a lot of the questions, able to answer them if you know the values. So, know your values! You learn them in phase one, and it's better to memorize those. Don't just, that's one thing I'll tell you for sure, to consistently go over, sorry guys, the back of my mouth is so swollen, and I'm getting my wisdom teeth taken out because of that, because I can't even talk properly anymore, but. So phase one, you'll start learning lab values and blood serum values. Don't just learn them, memorize them, because you won't be in my place today. That's one thing. Like, everything you're gonna learn in phase one and everything you're gonna learn in phase two eventually will stick to you no matter what you do, but lab values won't. So I would definitely say every single day, or whenever you remember, just go over your lab values, because that's very NCLEX-y. Everything else is like, comes common knowledge, and you will be bombarded with so much information. You're like, oh, how am I remember this? How am I gonna know this? You will know it, like, trust me, like, it's in there. So yeah, I'll keep you guys updated, and once again, happy birthday, Jackson! Love you, girl! Before, the first 2 days were overnight shifts and they were rough. The rest of the day shifts were great. So for a transition to practice, it's meant to be as realistic to once you have your license and you're on your own and you're just working by yourself with nobody over you. Yeah, so that's when it all comes together. Trust me, like, throughout this course and throughout clinical rotations, me personally, I felt like I did not know what I was doing. I had a bunch of information, jumbled and mumbled. Things are familiar, things I forgot. Like, you learn so much that you think you forgot it, but it's there somewhere. It's there, trust me. It doesn't go away. It's there. So, I had random information I forgot about, learning new skills on the floor. Once I was on the floor doing clinicals, I was just doing what I had to do to, like, survive. Like, just trying to have good bedside manner and just trying to survive because, like, I did not feel confident at all through clinical. I really just did what I had to do to get passing grade, and I moved on to next rotation. But I will say, 100% will say, transition to practice was the best experience for me. It was the experience I needed because now I really feel like I can do something. I felt like a nurse during that time. Like, by my 6th, 7th, and 8th shift, I was moving. I was comfortable. Like, I was good. I was like, oh, okay. I understand it now. So everything that I learned previously, like from class and through clinicals and labs, it all made sense. All made sense within those 7 shifts. So if you're like me, who felt like they didn't know what they were doing through clinicals, they didn't know what they was doing in class, they didn't know what they was doing in lab, trust me, by transition to practice, actually, if you have a good preceptor, which I had a great preceptor, so I hope you guys are blessed as I was, because my preceptor, she did me well. Like, I feel like 1,000% better. 1,000% better. So, yeah. So, if you, like, I'm sorry I'm babbling, but it's just, I have to stress this, because for me personally, I really felt so lost, but the minute I completed transition practice, it made sense. I was like, okay, I can honestly really do this. So, and I'm not the only one who feels this way too, because a lot of my friends are like, oh my God, this is not for me. I don't know if I could do this. But by the time they reach this point, they're like, okay, I got this. Trust me, like, it's gonna be rough, guys. It's gonna be rough. This course is like the devil. It will get you out of character. It will have you feeling crazy. it will test you from every angle, but just take it day by day, step by step, and you will survive. Like, you will survive, trust me. As I was going to like pull up YouTube and look at the comments, my iPad wants to die. BRB. So my iPad, ooh, let me fix this camera. My iPad finally turned on. Okay, let's go to YouTube and read some of these comments. Maybe I could pull up my Gmail. I'm recording a video where I look, you know, somewhat human and not washed out and tired. Okay, so somebody asked, right? Is it true that if you are dropped from the 68 Charlie course, then you become a frontline medic? Heck no! If you get dropped from the 68 Charlie course, you have a chance to be, you have a chance to, what's the correct term? Not reclass. Basically, okay, for some reason I'm having like a crazy brain fart and I can't think of the correct word, but if you fail out of the course, you have a chance to start over again with the next class if you really want to. And if that doesn't work, or if you're not approved to start over with the next class, you simply just pick a new MOS. You do not become frontline as a medic, no. No, 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 no. Okay, and if somebody else asks, can I ask, how long did you wait for the next class and what were you doing during that time? Okay, so this person's asking about when I was a holdover, because my original class was in DC, and because I didn't have my clearance ready, I was a holdover and I ended up staying in Texas. So I had to wait a month, 4 weeks, and that time, those 4 weeks were just, it was a bunch of, like, baloney. We were just sitting there. Yeah, it was a waste of time. Actually, they allowed us to go home. Yeah, that was good. Okay, someone said, thank you. Your videos are very helpful. Aww, that's my goal, guys. Help someone out. Okay. Alright. I ship out next month. Where could you be possibly stationed at 68 Charlie? What is recommended? What is a grade requirement for the testing method? Okay. So, this person asks, where can you possibly be stationed at 68 Charlie? You will be stationed where the Army needs you to be stationed. When you first get, after basic training, you'll reach Fort Sam Houston, Texas, and you'll fill out a wish list. You get to pick 3 overseas and like 3 in the United States. You might get lucky and get what you selected, but at the end of the day, the Army is going to place you where the Army needs you. I know where I'm going next, and if you really want to know where I'm going next, guys, you better comment, like, subscribe, and yeah, yeah, so comment if you want to know where I'm going next, and I'll make a video about where I'm going next. I'll show you guys my ERB if I'm able to. I don't know if I'm able to actually. Well, I'll reveal where I'm going next. Go ahead, comment, like it up, and I'll let you know where I'm going next. Yeah, I literally actually have less than 2 weeks left here. My NCLEX is on the 9th. What is a great So I don't know. Okay, so for the 6-day trolley course, a 76 is passing. Okay, as long as you get a 76 on each exam, you will pass that exam. Someone asked, were you a holdover? Yes, I was a holdover. I had to wait a month. That's all the questions I had. Oh, I thought I had more, but I didn't. So, anywho, you guys, enjoy the clips of my earlier... Well, I hope you guys enjoyed the clips from earlier this week. And keep asking questions. I'll answer them either in the reply. I'll either reply to in the comment, or I just post a video answering them. Yeah. So like, comment if you want to know where I'm going next. And you guys have a blessed Sunday and have a great week. And wish me luck. My NCLEX is on Tuesday.